Hey you guys, so I have like a series of cool things to do today with you guys. I knew I wanted to vlog because I haven't done that much this week. And I do have a shoulder workout from the previous week that I wanted to share with you guys that my husband helped me record, because I don't record by myself in the gym and bring a tripod along with me to my workouts because, well, too much rest time between sets and yeah, my workouts for me. So unless he's there, I don't capture any footage for you guys. But so you're gonna see a shoulder workout in this video, as well as I'm gonna make a cilantro lime crockpot chicken. I've been kind of seeing on Instagram and Snapchat, shout out to Jill Hawkins, because she's been doing this and kind of gave me this idea, and I thought that this would be a great meal for my husband and I both to enjoy while I'm on prep. So I kind of am adding my own little tweaks to it, and I have no idea how it's gonna come out, because like I said, I've never made this before. So this is live, sort of, not live. But what we've got here is I've got my crock pot ready to go. One lime I'm gonna fresh squeeze. Some free range, low sodium chicken broth. 4 chicken breasts. Dill relish made with sea salt. Ginger. And then some sparkling water, tangerine flavored. And some fresh cilantro. So let's put all this together. Baby, keep on turning me up.
Fresh herbs. All right.
So while my chicken is cooking, because I've got it on the 6-hour setting, so I can chat with you guys and go get my workout in. And yeah, so anywho, I wanted to talk a little bit about a little bit of an insecurity going forward with my run for two. As you guys know who've been following my channel, I have been Bikini Pro since 2014, and as of the beginning of this prep, I decided I would tackle a run for a figure pro card. So I figure is a smaller division, but it is far more competitive in the sense that many of the competitors there have much more muscle mass than I probably have at this point, and have been training four figure for probably somewhere along the lines the same or more than I have. So I'm trying to be realistic with myself, and knowing that I did set a pretty lofty challenge, I'm trying to prepare my headspace for this challenge. I also have to understand that there's a mental reward in the aspect of setting myself up for such a lofty goal. Just to the fact that I'm doing it is pretty freaking awesome, because not many competitors have done this by crossing over in my federation. So, you know, I have to give myself that mental, you know, pat on the back for doing that. However, I gotta be realistic with myself. Even if I don't get my pro card this time, you know, I will be disappointed, because I'm human and I've been working really, really hard, and I'm very, very competitive. I want to win and I want to be the best one up there, undeniably. But I also have to understand and respect that other women have been training for this, and they potentially could show up with far more mass to their back, size in their legs, than I have yet to allow my body to develop at this point in chasing my figure pro card. So, you know, I have to be respectful of that and be okay with, you know, setting such a lofty goal, knowing that, you know, I may not get it this time around. And that just gives me more, you know, fuel for my fire and more reason for me to take a longer off season and really improve my physique to bring, you know, the size I can if that doesn't happen for me this go around. But what I can look forward to is, you know, being up there on stage with some of these women who have put forth, you know, so much effort to their training and really get to know the figure division. And because, like I said, it is smaller. It is far more competitive in that sense, but it is a smaller niche of women doing figure in my federation. So, you know, I am excited about that, but I have to understand that I may lose. But did I really lose, or did I just set a big lofty goal? You know, I don't know. But yeah, so this is just a little scattered memo to myself and to you guys that sometimes you have to set those scary goals, but you also have to be realistic with yourself and realistic with, you know, your competition. Because yeah, I'm getting a little nervous at this point. I'm struggling with my back posing and bringing the width out in my back and lower lats. Coach wants me to try, you know, to really hit some specific movements in my back training to improve those areas. But again, I'm 4 weeks left. You know, am I going to have the size in my back that some of the competitors will have? Hard to say. But again, I'm proud of myself for what I've accomplished thus far, and I'm so excited to step on that stage in that division and really bring my A game and bring the best package I can. But yeah, so you have to be okay sometimes with, you know, understanding that big goals for yourself just make you work harder, but you can't get down on yourself if you potentially don't get the end result. But you know, I'm gonna give it all, and I'm gonna probably stop rambling here because I feel like I've repeated myself now. But yeah, so I'm gonna let my chicken cook. I'm gonna go train back, and you're gonna get to watch my shoulder training video, and then we might do a live test. Then we're gonna do a live taste of the actual chicken in the crock pot, because again, never had it. So trying it new, maybe hubby will be on camera for the trial. We'll see. So what you're seeing here is going to be my shoulder training for a high volume day. So my goal with volume days is to get 12 to 15 reps in at a moderate weight. I'm going to be pretty real with you guys. Volume days at this point in my prep are the hardest for me. I struggle through them. Typically I'm getting between 3 and 4 sets per exercise. Just depends on how productive I feel the sets are becoming.
Yes. 15. Yes. How many?
15.
Wow.
So my second movement is going to be the cambered bar upright rows. For upright rows right now, I do prefer the cambered bar. I feel like the grip allows me to have a really comfortable position for my wrist. So these had preloaded bars, so I did a nice drop set with these using the 50 and 60 pound. So the third movement in the set is going to be the bent over rear delt flies. With this movement, I drop weight to really focus on my elbow drive here. And as you'll see towards the end, I make some sort of association to a pterodactyl.
I can tear it back right now.
So the last movement in my straight sets is the seated dumbbell lateral raises. With this, I definitely had to go very moderate in weight and do a drop set in order to reach a high volume rep range. So the final set in my shoulder training is a superset with the high cable face pulls. And notice that I am really focusing again here on elbow drive with a nice hold at the contraction at the end of the movement. And I did a superset of that with the straight bar cable front raises. And for this particular set, I did try to go to failure, not really focusing on particular counting of my reps, just focusing on the movement entirely and not getting stuck in a rep range goal or number. I really hate when you do that. All right, so I'm back from my workout and I have prepped and finished the chicken and shredded it. So I used about a cup remaining of the liquid to kind of stir it in and keep it moist. And then, because I thought it needed a little bit of flavor, I added just a little bit more sea salt and Mrs. Dash Fiesta lime. So hubby is home and he's gonna do a taste test and let me know if he actually likes this chicken. So are you gonna come over here?
Sure.
How come you're not doing this live?
Well, I don't know how to do it live. It takes me a couple days to edit.
You can Periscope it.
Oh, I don't do that Periscope. What'd you think?
It's good.
You good? All right, so hubby is making, he's making tacos with it. I don't know if you can see it. So he's making tacos. And then I decided I'd have mine with my potatoes and asparagus. So, there's dinner, there's my day. Hope you enjoyed my shoulder workout and my little be bold, be brave chat I had with you guys. So be sure to subscribe if you like my channel. Give me a thumbs up and see you guys in my next video on my run for two.